We used to be a new wave band, but somehow along the way we turned into a rock band. And I'm not quite sure how it happened, except for the fact that maybe that we were away from everything that was going on and the rest of the world allows us the time to find what we really wanted to do. I always wanted to be in a rock band, but I guess maybe at the time that we started the band, I was kind of afraid to play rock music because it wasn't very much in vogue.
Chicago, borrow our arm start.
We need
About the Smashing Pumpkins. Who told you about them? When did you hear them the first time?
Because they're really good and they're nobody really actually likes them, so they're just kind of out there.
Okay, first of all, can I ask you for consent that we can use this for public broadcasting at any time?
Definitely.
But the guitar tone is just, I mean, it's like, they send me into another world, man. It's like, real relaxed.
I think that's Billy Corgan.
Relaxed. It's a relaxed, powerful type of escape, man. I mean, it's cool.
Satan?
Satan generally rules most of my daily activities. I sleep till 5, I don't see the sun, and I have sex with as many people as possible.
That's cool.
You know, being one of his minions and all, I feel kind of biased for this question. I threw up on a tilt-a-whirl once.
So it wasn't that bad for you, just the people underneath you, right?
No, it was all over me and all over everybody next to me, too.
If you could be any body part from any member of the band, which body part would it be and why?
Their hands.
Whose? Which?
Their toes.
If we ever add another member, we'll call you.
Man, it's short for fanatic, oh, man, remember that.
Cuba, we will stay cool and be somebody's fool this year. Cause they know who is righteous, what is bold. So
I hear you've been having some problems with your band, and I wonder, would you like to tell me about them?
I'm not sure if it's one individual or the band collectively, but maybe it's their footwear that really bothers me. I'm not sure if it's just any one shoe, but maybe just the thought of it. The thought of what's on their feet at any given moment distracts me.
Tell me if there's any way that you can see of having an effect on the situation so that you feel able to get close to them.
Well, I have given thought to this, and I suppose in a practical sense, I could maybe ask for different shoes or socks on our rider, and a rider is something that we have at every show. And, you know, they'll give us a deli tray, you know, candy, and we can put any sort of footwear we want on it. Maybe if I were to have those different exposed elements to them, maybe they would lighten up a little.
You've really lost me there. I hear you've been having some problems with your band, And I wonder, would you like to tell me about them?
I'm sorry if I don't mean to be insulting at all. I just don't really think that any amount of therapy is ever going to help this band. Jimmy is incredibly paranoid all of the time, and James, it's a different thing with him every week. It's, you know, one week he thought that his dog was possessed, and Billy flew off the handle and just couldn't take it anymore. So he said, you know, well, fine, let's get a witch doctor then. So we went to this witch doctor, and then the next month it was the tarot card reader, you know.
I hear you've been having some problems with your band, and I wonder, would you like to tell me about them? And put them here. That's Darcy and the other two men. And I'd like to get you to get across to these people how you feel when you get mocked, knowing that there are no consequences except you feeling better about yourself because they're not in the room.
Billy, sometimes when you tell me that my clothes are funny and my hair is too long, it makes me feel really bad.
Getting into blaming and criticizing him for how he is. And maybe he is that way. What I want you to do is
he's a duck.
Tell him how you want. No, but he is a duck. But the person who using him as a symbol for is not a duck, right?
Right.
You can just pretend he's in the chair and take that away if you like.
No,
and tell
him. I like the duck.
Okay.
Darcy, I really think you're a cool person, and it would really make me happy if you would just try to appreciate me for who I am, because I really go out of my way to try to be nice to you. James, it made me feel really bad that you cut all your hair off right as mine was getting long, and I felt that it was kind of another ploy of yours to make me feel like distance from the band, and I deserve to be respected by you and everybody else.
I hear you've been having some problems with your band, and I wonder, would you like to tell me about them?
Just let me make this analogy. You want to go to the circus, and to get in the circus it costs you 5 pence.
Yeah.
So you stand in line, you don't have 5 pence, but you really want to go to the circus. So someone comes along and says, well, I'll take you in the circus and I'll pay the 5 pence, but you got to pay me back later. So you get taken to the circus, they take you out. Oh, okay, well, when are you going to pay me back? I don't know, I'll get around to it sooner or later. That's the story of the band. The first band that I had was this band called The Marked. We played in Florida around 1986, and the band wasn't very good, but it was kind of like the same kind of idea behind the Pumpkins, which was loud music and quiet music and trying to put it all together, and my singing wasn't very good and blah, blah, blah. And so I kind of came back with my tail between my legs to Chicago and moved back in with my dad, and that's where I kind of hatched the idea for the Pumpkins. So there I was, like, living with my dad, playing in my room, and I met this guy named Len, who was a friend of James, and that's how I met James, and we just kind of started writing these scary little doomy goth pop songs together. And then we started talking about, okay, now we're going to form this band, and James was in this other band called the Feds, which turned out to be another band. I can't remember what their name was now, but, and then I met Darcy on the street one day, and we started playing as a three-piece with the drum machine, and then somebody saw us playing and said, oh, I know this drummer, and that's how I met Jimmy, and then we've been together ever since.
If you guys could be any member of the band, who would you want to be, and why?
I wouldn't mind being James.
Why?
He takes cool pictures.
Yeah?
For those singles, for those UK singles.
Yeah?
So I think he must live like this cool artsy life, you know?
Time to walk, walk. Bug, time to go outside. Outside.
What else can I say about my dog, Bug? I guess he's a little crazy. But then again, I guess we all are. We've done a lot of growing in the past 5 years. Bug is a friend, a companion, and a dog. I too have grown mentally and spiritually over these last few years, becoming a strong, responsible adult. In the wake of the success of the band, Bug and I are often torn apart by fame. He understands this and still cares. For he is a strangely perceptive dog. This bike I ride with Bug alongside is but a metaphor for the future. We don't know where we're going, when we'll get there, but we're happy doing it together. This is the story of Bug and I.
Thank you. from me that has not already been taken. And there's no stories that can be written that have not been written. And there's no amount of bullshit can be stacked high. And there's no amount of daggers that are small enough to miss your
Hi there, Manny Chevrolet here with Butch Vig. Butch, you're producing the Smashing Pumpkins. It sounds great.
You are correct, sir.
Billy, you want to start another one of these with just a click reference on the start? And then do that guitar thing over it?
I don't know if that throws them off, though. Just do a quick start.
So tell me a little something about the Pumpkins. You've worked with them before.
Yeah, I worked with them on, actually the first thing I did was a Sub Pop single.
Mm-hmm.
And Jonathan called me up from Sub Pop and said, there's this band in Chicago that is awesome and you gotta work with them.
So what's the name of the new album?
It's called Siamese Dream.
Siamese Dream.
The Search for the Yeti.
The first record was very sad. There were a lot of sad songs. This record is very happy. There's a lot of happy songs. Is this too much bullshit for you to deal with? It?
This guitar emits sad tones.
Very sad tones.
This guitar brings much joy to everyone that I know.
And what is this?
This is one of the secrets to our secret sound. This is the Mutron biphase. We run everything through it, everything. Everything. It's fabulous.
This here is my sitar.
Oh
yeah.
Are you using this a lot on the record?
No. We just think it's really cool to show people that we have a sitar.
In fact,
so cool that we can't get it open. This, of course, is the Mellotron, which is most notably used by the Beatles. It's a precursor to the sampler that used actual tape. But instead of the Beatles used orchestral noises, we used just people screaming.
What's this button for?
I never really took any
you have no
classes,
schooling or
no
anything?
School. Just I just kind of learned by the seat of my pants. Yeah.
So why don't you tell me a little bit more about Butch?
He's changed a lot lately.
We took this from here and we moved it over here, and then we took this here and put that over there, and then we turned it upside down and ran the whole thing backwards.
He just doesn't seem like his old self.
How do you guys like working together?
As much as any two men could like working together.
Good answer.
I gotta go. Bye. One more thing. What do you think keeps a band together?
Alright, end of the charade. Get the fuck out of here.
Bye.
Thank you.
La 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 la, down. And now, a few words with Jimmy Chamberlain, up close and personal, as asked by James Iha.
Tell us something about Chicago, or your hometown, Joliet.
My hometown, Joliet, is pretty much a crime-ridden wasteland full of people who'll stab you in the back at any opportunity. I noticed that now that the band's become popular, a lot of the people that used to beat me up when I was a kid all of a sudden are my friends. As far as Chicago goes, I think it's a very blue-collar town. I think it's full of a lot of beer-drinking, 9-to-5 working, wife-beating, chauvinistic pigs.
Let's figure out some other questions.
What do you think about Jimmy when you play music?
Sometimes I think about nothing at all. Actually, I try not to think about what I'm playing. I just try and pretty much let my emotions run the game.
What do you think your drums sound like?
Besides for like full rich warm tones, I like them to sound like a small bore-sized drill going through your skull.
Name some of your formative groups.
I was in a band called the Sushi Cowboys, Stadium Drive, Eddie Carosa's Polka Party, JP and the Cats, Mojo Blues Band, and the Skittles.
When you look back, do you ever cringe?
Yeah, I think just about every time I look back, I cringe. I think it's an appreciative cringe. I mean, every time you do something stupid or you do something wrong or you do something that doesn't really make sense to you now in the past, it's always been a learning experience.
Any advice to up-and-coming drummers, musicians?
Stay away from the deli tray.
Thanks for taking your time out with me today, Jimmy.
I hope this comes out okay.
ご紹介しましょう。スマッシングパンプキンズの皆さんですけどもね、
はい、
皆さんはカレッジチャートでもナンバーワン、それからカレッジチャートの最優秀新人賞にあたるデビューアルバムオブジイヤーも獲得したということですよね。
はい、そしてなんとメンバーの中には日本人の方がいらっしゃるとお聞きしたんですけども、あれ後ろの方ですか？
こんばんは。
そう、
こんばんは。
日本語喋れます？
日本語だったの？そうなんですか？
再生なんで。
あ、そうですか。
He's a second generation.
あ、それは I'm sorry. ごめんなさいね。
スマッシングパンプキンズっていうのはどうしてこういう名前をつけたんですか？
So how did you get the name of Smashing Pumpkins?
Funny name.
Yes. Interesting. Why? Funny. Any reason?
God. God's joke.
神の冗談だ。
We thought it was funny too.
神がくれた。神がくれたジョークだという。
天の声ってことですか？
とっても異様な雰囲気を持っている。
なんだかすごい独特の雰囲気が。
独特の雰囲気がありますね、皆さん。演奏の方もですね、どういう感じかぜひ聞いてみたいと思いますけど、じゃあスタンバイの方お願いしたいんです
が。スタンバイしてください。
よろしくお願いいたします。
演奏の方のスタンバイ。
スタンバイ、プリーズ。
大丈夫ですか、皆さん。
そして。
Smashing Pumpkins and Red Red Meat.
Which one's your favorite?
I enjoy both of them. Guy Lombardo.
You had to pick one.
I guess I'd have to go with Red Red Meat.
Why is that?
It just sounds rare to me.
What do you think of the new album?
Well, I'd have to ask my friend here.
Hey, I've got that.
Oh, that's great.
It is spectacular.
Is it?
What's your biggest selling t-shirt?
Either the album cover or the one with the hearts.
Who buys the one with the hearts, girls?
Yeah, more girls.
And the guys buy the?
The same t-shirt.
What about hats? Who buys the hats?
Nobody.
I think it's going to be a wild night tonight.
In der ausverkauften Alabama-Halle warten Sie jetzt alle ganz ungeduldig auf das Live-Konzert. Und zwar von einer der erfolgreichsten jungen amerikanischen Bands aus Chicago. Hier sind Smashing Pumpkins!
Yeah, you can stop throwing cups now. The joke is over. Stoppin' ze throwin' ze cuppin'. Danke.
Stay.
from their groundbreaking record, 1989. Fabulous! It's only right and natural, ladies and gentlemen, I give you the Frogs!
I've always wanted to be in showbiz. And now here I am. You started in 1980. Why?
Between us, we probably have about 1,500 songs. All of them good.
I only play for money. I don't give a fuck about the fans.
You know, God put me on this earth for one reason. To rock. I think Grandma would be proud of us if she was still alive. I think Grandma would be into the Frogs.
In order of importance, Jesus, Gary Coleman, the Frogs. Yeah, I think that's your trinity.
Why do you wear wings and wigs? If I may ask.
Oh, Mom was always wondering why I was into sports. Oh, Mom was always wondering why I was staying after school. I'm into sports, Mom, and also I'm in the locker room with the boys. I'm in the shower and I drop the soap every time. Almost, uh-huh, 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 almost. No one knows a homo like us. We love homos.
I find it mildly offensive, but intriguing.
When that's broken, maybe we should throw it.
That's what it sounds like when you're banging Grandma.
Oh, don't give me this. We don't fuck Grandma routine. Don't give me that. Fuck me. Love you.
You try in this rock and roll career for size. See if you like it.
Thank you.
are always asking us, like, what's it like to be famous? And when I think of famous, I think about people, like, who kill people, and I think about people who, like, need to run for political office. Being in a rock band is just an excuse not to have a job. We're just trying to postpone mortality just a couple, 5 minutes, you know? A lot of people think that, like, the early days of a band are like the glory days, and that when you become like this bigger band that it's not as fun, but I think that we're probably having more fun now than ever because we don't have the pressure of trying to hold down jobs and play music and all these kinds of things. We can just play music all the time. It's easy to point to things that people can touch. Record sales are things that people can touch. Videos are things that people can touch. But time and memory washes all that away. And so ultimately it has to do with your conscience and your integrity and what you feel. And all I would hope for is that we're doing it because we want to do it and not because we're supposed to. Touring on Siamese Dream has probably been some of the best experiences of our life. Not because of the success of the record or the size of the shows, but just because I think we finally feel that we're doing and being what we always hoped we would be, which is our own band, and be recognized as that.
No pain.
babe. And you lie to yourself when you lie in your bed. And you lie to yourself. Thank you.
Watch my lips as they move. Are they not striking up close? Pull away from me. What shall you see?